I'm Alexis Van Herkman, and welcome to Resolve in a Rush, where you'll learn DaVinci Resolve grading and finishing techniques in under 5 minutes. In this episode, we're going to take a look at a nice fast shortcut for dealing with shots where you have mixed lighting. So for example, in this clip here, you can see that I've created this pretty elaborate grade that is treating the whole interior of this room exactly the way I want it to be treated, but I've got a lot of really bright blue light coming in through this window. This is a result of the cool sunlight mixing with the tungsten light that's illuminating the rest of the scene. I have a mixed lighting situation with two very different color temperatures. If creatively I wanted this to be this way, that's great. But if you don't, it's a really easy way of doing this. So the first thing I'm going to do is create a new node, which is where I'm going to make this adjustment. This is going to be a secondary correction. I'm just going to affect the window. I don't want to touch anything else in the scene. So the first thing I'll do is to turn on a circular window. I'm just going to keep it simple. And I'm going to shrink the circular window to match the size of that door, because the blue light only falls off a short ways from the door. It can't quite compete with the tungsten lighting inside here. So I don't need a giant window, and I don't want to overlap with his shirt, because I don't want what I'm about to do to affect the blues that happen to be in his shirt. With that done, I go back to my curves, and because I created that window, any curve adjustment that I make is going to be restricted to the inside of that window, which is why this is a secondary operation. I'm going to use the hue versus sat curves. These are some of my favorite curves. In fact, if there's one control I use almost more than all the others, aside from lift gamma gain, it's probably hue versus sat. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to click the shortcut buttons to create control points for cyan and blue, because what I'm finding objectionable is this range of cyan through blue color. And then by dragging these control points down, you can see that I'm selectively desaturating just the blue and cyan that I don't like by varying amounts. And because I've got that window there, this desaturation isn't spilling into his shirt, which I like, or any of the other blues throughout the scene that I like. And if I turn this node off and on to get a before, after, you can see that this small adjustment, while I didn't completely desaturate it, there's still some color out there, brings the whole region outside this door much more in line with the rest of the scene. So now it doesn't stick out like a sore thumb. I hope you found this useful. If you want more information on editing or grading in DaVinci Resolve, I strongly suggest you check out my editing in DaVinci Resolve 11 and grading in DaVinci Resolve 11 titles available from Ripple Training. I'm Alexis Van Herkman. Thanks for watching.